Daddy. Daddy. Please don't kill me.
Hello?
Precious eagle cactus fruit. Help us.
This dawning epoch, this age of reason, an empire grown fat, ripe for the bleeding. My children.
Trapped, Mandus. Far below us. The machine is fouled. It is breached. It is flooded. The bulkheads are down. The children are engaged. If you help me, I can help you release them. Restore the power, Mandus. Drain the flooding and restart the great engines.
How? Where should I go? Hello? Hello? I will cry all the way home. I will have none.
I will have none at all.
It's coming. Come on, Daddy. It's this way.
Slow, coach. It's this way.
The shaking ground you feel is our attempts to clear the floodwaters. Treachery, Mandus. We were undone. Your children are trapped by this act. You must find them before it is too late.
What do you need me to do? How can I find them?
Always deeper, Mandus. Through the piston room and into the tunnels, then find the bilge and flush the rotten water. I will help you where I can, but you must be swift, my little friend.
Thank you. dies. Small bones in the orchard. I have carried this world on my back with its legs about me. Damn this wretched soul. I am given birth to nothing but machinery.
Hold still, for God's sake, hold still, child. Don't let it get into your eyes. I'm gonna rinse it out now. There. It will be fine. You just need to lie down. Keenock, look to your brother. How many times have I told you not to play in the cellar?
I told you he'd come.
Extraordinary. Quite extraordinary. And you built it all. Good old man. You have been busy.
It is wonderful how tragedy focuses the mind. What else was I to do? Fall into grief, pine, and fade in my hopelessness? Why not then simply die in that jungle amongst those dead temples?
Thank you.
Come on, Papa. Let's climb this one. I can see more pictures at the top. This way, Papa. Come and see. Will it hatch? Can we take it home?
Yes, my darlings. Of course we can take it home.
Your faith shackles your vision, Professor. It is an iron coffin that keeps you from grasping the future. We require a new deity, one of steam and the wheel, of magnetism and progress. The old god is nothing more than a lamed hog, spitting back offal at mankind.
Thank you.
Listen, Papa. Hold the egg to your ear. You can hear the sea.
Water in his shoes. Always the water and the sparks of the embers of the wheels. It's too bony! It's too damn bony!
These men, Professor, these so-called men of vision, they would shackle the masses to a wheel and turn it till their backs break. All for that opiate, the lure of profit. And these fools who lackey them, these priests, these officials, this government, they make pigs of us all.
How to break the cycle? You cannot simply remove the promise of a better world for these unfortunates. In the workhouses, in the orphanages, the belief in heaven is surely the only succor one can find.
We do not need to wait. We can bring forth paradise now. We can speed the passion. With only a small sacrifice, we can hold the apocalypse. With just a small sacrifice, we can free our shackles and deliver them to paradise now.
Thank you.
find the entrance nearby. The children weep in the darkness, and the floodwaters continue to rise.
Over there, place it in the corner. What? You think I speak Prussian? Do I look like an inbred hop, sir? Who gives a damn what it contains? Just set it down carefully and leave me be!
It fell onto his hands and they eroded in front of me. To stumps. To stumps. Next time we will use an equal mix of infusion vitae and orgone disperser. No, no, just take him out. You can dump him in the river for all I care.
Isn't it dangerous allowing this filthy discharge to collect so close to the core?
We can use the flow to drive the turbines. There will always be a torrent of excreta flooding through these tunnels. We can use this to supplement the steam production and ensure constancy.
God, the stench! This fecal matter is the true product of the age.
Thank you.
Mr. Mandus. Drain the waters. Open the way to the bilge pumps. We are waiting for you.
We can save them. We can set them free. We can replace a rotten old world with a clean new one.
Mr. Mandus, you sound every bit the fanatic.
Well, how can I be otherwise, Professor? How can any man of ethics simply stand by and watch this world drown in its own excrement?
And your engineer, this visionary with whom you have embarked upon this course, does he share your views?
Indeed he does. The poor fellow has seen it all before. Now, this is not the first great civilization he has wept for.
And so you set about things immediately upon your return.
Naturally. These things cannot be left to rot upon the tree.
And sponsors were remarkably easy to find. I tell you, Professor, a trail of greed brings rich men to your door like pigs to truffles.
You seem to have undergone quite a profound conversion in Mexico, Mr. Mandus.
You could not have seen it yourself and not, Professor. As we disembarked, even through my fever, I saw the detritus of this so-called progress. I saw starvation and disease, rot and destruction polluting the waters of the Empire. We are ruiners, you and I, and all of us, and we
may... I said we were.
Ahead, the trickled to still waters. I dragged myself deeper into the temple, downward heaven, towards a wind that held the voices of my children, beckoning me to set them free.
and who came then to London, and you set me upon a mantelpiece, and then you went into the house and gathered the servants, and we set you and I on recrafting them, and then you went into the garden and buried those tiny shattered skulls. A rogue. For your children, Mandus, to spare them the world you have created. For us all.
I will rise to bleach the sky and still the water. I will spin the world wheel and set the future upon the path to redemption.
Where are my children? You promised me my children.
My time is come. More pig. More pig.
And, emerging, I raised my head to an uncaring sun, and I cursed this world of pain and despair. This civilization built on the ricketed bones of the unfortunate, on the greed and swell of mammon and empire. Cradling a stone egg in my jacket, I kissed my children farewell, and I crawled my way home.
A cleansing fire always burns, little Mandus, but it purifies and it makes anew. Did it hurt to carve out the fevered flesh? Did it hurt to cut free the gangrenous foot? Ask instead this. Can we save them?
When did I say that? That is not me. That is not me!
Thank you.
my piggies! Kill them all!
Children.
Will they be free?
Yes, my friend. Drained and bled and freed from the prison of the flesh. Free to ascend as smoke to the stars.
And the good? The worthy? How will we save them?
Show me these worthy, Mandus. Show me these good. I do not see them.
machine. I know what you fear. I will rain excrement into your very soul. I will destroy you.
You are too late, Mandus. My great works are almost begun.
Again, at the foot of those stairs, towards the red light of the nursery, sunset in the window like a bleeding sky, the horizon a slit throat, the seeping dark to drain the guilt from us. I am the jaguar-faced man. I am the feathered serpent. This priesthood is mine.
I can meet him, your great engineer. How marvelous! I must say, Mr. Mandus, my excitement is almost unseemly.
Yes, I can see that. Step this way, Professor. I will be right behind you.
Mandus? Mandus, where the devil are you? I can't see a damn thing. Mandus!
We are the pig, Professor. We are all the pig.
I climb in stillness now. Blue water runs in my veins, now I am clean. I carry the knife of this factory, the bowl of this mill. I am come to collect you from your fields and your furnaces. I will gather you into the white clouds. I will gather you to me, and I will take you home. Take my children.
I, Mandus, of all the blood we have spilled together, the first drops fell from your hands alone.
Then I am damned for a filicide, and everything is lost. Spare you. I would have given my soul to spare you this world and its loan. Oh, my children. My children. What have I done? What have I become? I will put it right, my darlings. All of my wrongs will be righted. All of my sins washed clean.
Misguided crusade, and let me save them. You may hate me, Mandus, but I have seen the future, your 20th century, and let me tell you this, a far greater slaughter awaits you there. I seek to save the world by blood now, before millions fall beneath history, pushed under by blade, bullet, and gas.
Thank you.
It is time to end this madness.
Oh, God help me. I am lost in the dried paper soul of the world.
Humanity, ridding them of their painful, stupid, pointless lives.
Mandus, stop. Think about what you're doing. For your children, Mandus.
Do not speak of my children, monster.
I did not kill your children, Mandus. You sacrificed them on the temple steps, knowing what the coming century would do to them. Your sons will drown, lungs full of mud and shrapnel on the banks of the Somme. You wanted to save them from the horror to come. That is the vision we shared. Everything we have built to avert this coming nightmare. You and I are one. We are the same. Our souls are entangled. We deserve to make them free.
Into pain. A child's shadow burnt into the brickwork. A house of skulls in the jungle. The innocent Mandus trod and bled and gassed and starved and beaten and murdered and enslaved. This is your coming century. They will eat the Mandus. They will make pigs of you all, and they will bury their scalps into your ribs, and they will eat your hearts. Please, Mandus, no. For your children.
I lay there and watched the god I had created die. At the end, when we were cold as the stone we had hewn his body from, when the lights were nearly all extinguished, we heard, in the silent distance, the man-pigs singing to one another. Then, as the last lights were gone, and we lay together in the deep, they drifted away, and all was silent. Such a silence I have never known. And as the dust settled on my open eyes, and we lay together embraced forever, I heard, miles above us, the sounds of the city turning over in its sleep. A church bell ringing out. And in that moment, the new century was born.